Professor Dr. Manoj Kumar will give lecture on the Porter's five force analysis, which is in the topic of the strategic management of the syllabus. In 1979, the Harvard Business Review published the article, How Competitive Force Shapes Strategy, by the Harvard professor Michael Porter. It started a revolution in that strategy field. In subsequent decades, Porter five forces have shaped a generation of the academic research and the business practice. The unit explores how competitive analysis can be done using Porter's five forces model. The five forces model is shown in the figure. Porter's five forces model. The threat to the new entrant, threat of the substitutive product, of buyers, bargaining power of the suppliers, and bargaining power of the buyers. Rivalry among the existing forces. In essence, the job of the strategy is to understand and cope with the competition. However, managers define competition too narrowly, as if it occurs only among today's direct competitors. Yet competition for profits goes beyond established industry rivals. It includes four other competitive forces as well: customers, suppliers, potential entrants, and substitutes. The five forces model developed by the Michael E. Porter has been the most commonly used analytical tool for examining competitive environment. According to this model, the intensity of competition in an industry depends on the five basic forces. These five forces are threat of the new entrants, intensity of rivalry among industry competitors, bargaining power of the buyers, bargaining power of the suppliers, threat of substitute product and services. Each of these forces affect a firm's ability to compete in the given market. Together, they determine the profit potential for a particular industry. To understand industry competition and profitability, one must analyze industry's underlying structure in terms of the five forces as shown in the figure 4.1. In figure 4.1, the Porter's five force model have been given here. Porter argues that the stronger each of these forces are, the more limited is the ability of the established company to raise prices and earn greater profit. With Porter's framework, a strong competitive force can be regarded as a threat because it depresses profits. A weak competitive force can be viewed as an opportunity because it allows a company to earn greater profits. The strength of the five forces may change with time as industry conditions change. For example, in industry such as airlines, textiles, and hotels, where these forces are intense, almost no company earns attractive return on investment. In pharmaceutical and toiletry, where these forces are being in, many companies earn attractive profit. Understanding the competitive forces and their underlying causes reveal the roots of an industry's current profitability while providing a framework for anticipating and influencing competition and profitability over time. Understanding industry structure is also essential to the effective strategic positioning. Defending against the competitive forces and shaping them in company's favor are crucial to strategy. Forces that shape competition. The configuration of the five forces differ from industry to industry. For example, in the market, the commercial aircraft fears rivalry among existing competitors, Airbus and Boeing, and the bargaining power of the buyers of the aircraft are the strong, while threat to the entry, the threat of the substitute, and the power of the supplier are more benign. Thus, the strongest competitive force of the forces determine the profitability of an industry and becomes the most important to the strategy formulation. the threat of the new entrants. The first of the Porter's five force model is the threat of the new entrants. New entrants bring new capacity of substantial resources to an industry with a desire to gain market share. Established company already operating in an industry often attempt to discourage new entrants from the entering the industry to protect their share of the market and profits. Particularly when big new entrants are diversifying from other market into industry, they can leverage existing capability and cash flow to shake up competition. Pepsi did this when it entered the bottled water industry. Microsoft did when it began to offer internet browser, and Apple did when it entered the music distribution business. The threat of the new entrants therefore puts a cap on the profit potential of an industry. When the threat is high, existing company hold down their prices or boost investment to deter new competitors. And the threat of entry in an industry depends on the height of entry barriers, factors that make it costly for the new entrants to enter industry, that are present and on the retaliation from the entrenched competitor. If entry barriers are low and newcomers expect little retaliation, the threat of entry is high and industry profits will be moderate. It is the threat of entry, not whether entry actually occurs, that holds down profitability. Another forces is the barrier to the entry. Entry barriers depend on the advantage that existing company have relative to new entrant. There are seven major sources, economics of the sale. These are the relative cost of the advantage associated with the large volume of the production that the lower company cost structure. The cost of the product per unit declines as the volume of production increases. This discourages new entrants to the enter on a large scale. If the new entrant decides to enter on a large scale to obtain economies of the sale, it has to bear high risk associated with a large investment. A further risk is that the increased supply of the products will depress prices and results in the vigorous retaliation by the established company. For this reason, the threat of the new entrant is reduced when established company have economies of scale. Example, in microprocessor, existing company such as the Intel are protected by the economies of scale in research, chip fabrication, and the consumer marketing. Another source is the product differentiation. Brand loyalty is the buyer's preference for the differentiated product of any established company. Strong brand loyalty makes it difficult for new entrant to take the market share away from the established company. It reduces threat of entry because of the task of breaking down well-established customer preferences is too costly for them. Capital requirement, the need to invest large financial resources in order to compete can deter new entrants. Capital may be necessary not only for the fixed asset, but also to extend customer credit. Build inventory and fund startup losses. The barrier is particularly great if the capital is required for the unrecoverable expenditure, such as the upfront advertising or research and development. While major corporations have the financial resources to invade almost any industry, the capital requirement in certain fields limits the pool of the likely entrants. It is important not to overstate the degree to which the capital requirement alone deter entry. If industry returns are attractive and are expected to remain so, and if the capital markets are efficient, investors will provide new entrants with the funds they need. For example, in airlines industry, financing is available to the purchase expensive aircraft because of their resale value. And that is why there have been a number of the new airlines in almost every region. Switching costs are the one-time cost that customer has to bear to the switch from one product to the another. When switching costs are higher, customers can be locked up in the existing product if the new entrants offer a better product. Thus, the higher the switching costs are, the higher is the barrier to entry. Enterprise resource planning software is an example of a product with very high switching cost. One, a company has installed SAP's ERP system, the cost of the moving to a new vendor are astronomical. Access to the distribution channel. The new entrants need to secure distribution channel for the product can create a barrier to the entry. The established company have already tied up distribution channel. For example, a new food item may have to displace others from the supermarket shelf via price breaks. Promotion, intense selling efforts for the some other means, the more limited the wholesale or the retail channels are, tougher will be the entry into an industry. Sometimes, if the barrier is so high, a new entrant must create its own distribution channel, as Timex did in the watch industry in the 1950s. Cost disadvantage independent of the size. Some existing company may have advantage other than the size of the economy of sales. These are derived from proprietary technology. Preferential access to the new to the raw material sources, government subsidy, and favorable geographical location. Favorable geographical location. Established brand entity, cumulative experience, new entrants may not have these advantages. Government policy, historically, government regulation have constituted a major entry barrier into the many industry. The government can limit or even foreclose entry into the industry with such control as license requirement and limits on access to raw material. The liberalization policy of the Indian government relating to the deregulation, delicensing, and decontrol of prices opened up the economy to the many new entrepreneurs. If entry barriers are very high, new firms may still enter an industry if they perceive that the benefits outweigh the substantial cost of the entry. Such a situation creates excess capacity in the industry and sparks off intense price competition that might express the return for the all players, new entrants as well established company. So the strategy must be mindful of the creative ways newcomers might find to circumvent apparent barriers. Expected retaliation. How new entrants believe that the existing company may react will also influence their decision to enter or stay out of the industry. If reaction is vigorous and protected enough, the profit potential in the industry can fall below the cost of the capital for the participants. Existing company often use public statement to send message to the new entrants about their commitment to defending market share. New entrants are likely to fear expected retaliation if the existing company have previously responded vigorously to the new entrant. Existing company possess substantial resources to the fight back. Existing company seem likely to cut prices to protect their market share. Industry growth is slow, so newcomers can gain volume only one by taking the market share from the existing company. An analysis of the entry barriers and expected retaliation is obviously crucial for any company contemplating entry into the new industry. The challenge is to find ways to surmount the entry barriers without nullifying the potentiality, profitability of the industry. Another one is the intensity of rivalry among the competitors. The second of the Porter's five force model is the intensity of the rivalry among the established company within an industry. Rivalry means the competitive struggle between company in industry to gain market share from each other. Firms use tactics like the price discounting, advertising campaigns, new product introduction, and increased customer service or the warranty. Intense rivalry lowers the prices and raises cost. It squeezes profit out of an industry. Thus, intense rivalry among the established company constitute a strong threat to the profitability. Alternatively, if rivalry is less intense, companies may have the opportunity to raise prices or reduce spending on advertising, etc., which leads to the higher level of the industry profits. The intensity of the rivalry is greatest under the following condition. Numerous competitors are equally powerful competitors. when there are many computers in an industry, or if the computers are roughly of the equal size and power, the intensity of rivalry will be more. Any move by one firm matched by an equal counter move in such situation, rivals find it hard to avoid poaching business. Slow industry growth turns competition into the fight, because the only path to growth is to take sales away from a competitor. High fixed but low marginal cost. This creates the intense pressure for the competitive to cut prices below their average cost, even close to their marginal cost, to steal customers. Example, many paper and aluminium businesses suffer from this problem, especially if demand is not growing. Lack of differentiation or the switching cost. If product or services of the rivals are nearly identical and these are few switching costs, this encourages competitors to cut prices to win the new customers. Years of the airline's price wars affect these circumstances in that industry. Capacity augmentation in large increments. If the only way a manufacturer can increase capacity is in a large increment, such as building of a new plant, it will run the new plant at the full capacity to keep its unit cost low. Such capacity addition can be very disruptive to the supply demand balance and cause the selling prices to fall throughout the industry. High exit barrier. Exit barrier keep a company from leaving the industry. Exit barrier can be economic, strategic, or the emotional factors that keep more firms competing, even though they may be year low or the negative returns on their investment. If the exit barrier are high, company become locked up in a non-profitable industry where overall demand is static or declining. Each capacity remains in use and the property of the healthy computers suffer as the sick ones hang on. What are the common exit barriers? Common exit barriers are investment in a specialized asset like plant and machinery are of little or no value and cannot be put to the alternative use, so they have to be continued. High cost of exit, such as a retrenchment benefit, etc., that have to be paid to the redundant workers when a company ceases to operate. Emotional attachment to an industry keep owners or employees unwilling to exit from an industry for the sentimental reasons. Economic dependence on the industry, when the firm depend on a single industry for revenue and profit. Government and social pressure discourage exit of the industry out of concern for the job loss. Strategic interrelationship between the business unit and other prevent exit because of the shared facility and image, so on. Another forces are the bargaining power of the buyers. The third Porter's five competitive forces is the bargaining power of the buyer. Bargaining power of buyer refers to the ability of buyers to bargain down the price charged by the firms in the industry, or driving up the cost of the firm, depending better product quality and service by forcing lower prices and the rising cost. Powerful buyers can squeeze profits out of the industry. Thus, powerful buyers should be reviewed as a threat. Alternatively, if buyers are in a weak bargaining position, the firm can raise the prices, cut cost on quality and service, and increase their profit levels. Buyers are powerful if they have a more negotiation leverage than the firm in the industry, using their clout primarily to pressure price reduction. According to Porter, buyers are the most powerful under the following condition. There are few wars. If there are few buyers, or each one does bulk purchases, then they have more bargaining power. Large buyers are particularly powerful in industry like the telecommunication equipment, offshore drilling, and the bulk chemicals. High fixed cost and low marginal cost increase the pressure on the rivals to keep capacity falling through the discount. The products are standard or undifferentiated. If the products purchased from the firm are standard or undifferentiated, the buyers can easily find alternative source of the supply. Then buyers can play one company against the other as in the commodity gain market. The buyer faces low switching cost. Switching cost lock the buyer to a particular firm. If switching costs are low, buyers can easily switch from one form to the product to the another. The buyer earns low profit. If the buyer is under pressure to trim its purchasing cost, the buyer is price sensitive and bargains more. The quality of buyer's product. If the quality of the buyer's product is little affected by the industry product, buyers are more price sensitive. Most of the FF source of the buyer power can be attributed to consumers as a group as well as to industrial and commercial buyers. The buying power of retailers is determined by the same factor with one important addition. Retailers can gain significant bargaining power over manufacturer when they can influence consumers' purchasing decision as they do in the audio component, jewelry, appliances, sporting goods, etc. are examples. Bargaining power of the suppliers. The fourth of Porter's five force model is the bargaining power of the supplier. Supplier are companies that supply raw material, components, equipment, machinery, and associated products. Powerful supplier make more profits by changing their high prices, limiting quality of the services, or shifting the cost of the industry or participant. Powerful suppliers squeeze profit out of an industry, and thus there are a threat. For example, Microsoft has contributed to the erosion of the profitability among the PC makers by rising prices on the operating system. PC makers competing fiercely for the customers have limited freedom to raise their prices accordingly. A supplier's bargaining power will be high under the following condition. Few suppliers. When the supplier group is dominated by the few companies and is more concentrated than the firm to whom it sells an industry is called the concentrated. The suppliers can then dictate prices, quality, and the terms. Product is differentiated. When suppliers offer products that are unique or differentiated or built up switching costs, it cuts off the firm's option to play one supplier against the other. For example, the pharmaceutical company that offer patented drugs with the distinctive medical benefits have more power over hospital, drug buyers, etc. Dependence of supplier group on the firm. When supplier sell several firms and the firm does not represent a significant fraction of its sales, supplier are prone to the exert power. In other words, the supplier group does not depend heavily on the industry for new revenue. Suppliers serving many industry will not be hesitant to extract maximum profit from each one. If a particular industry accounts for a large portion of suppliers group volume or profit, however, suppliers will want to protect the industry through the reasonable prices. Importance of the product of the firm. When the product is an important input to the firm's business, or when such inputs are important to the success of a firm's manufacturing process or product quality, the bargaining power of supplier is high. Threat of the forward integration. When the supplier poses a credible threat of the integrating forward, this provides a check against the firm's ability to improve the terms by which it purchases. Lack of the substitute. The power of even large powerful suppliers can be checked if they compete with suppliers. But if they are not obliged to compete with the substitute, as they are not readily available, the supplier can exert power. The last and the fifth threat of the substitute product is the fifth Porter's five force model. The fifth of Porter's five force model is the threat of the substitute products. A substitute performs the same or a similar function as an industry product. Video conferences are a substitute for the travel. Plastic is a substitute for aluminium. Email is a substitute for email. All firms within an industry compete with the industry producing substitute products. For example, company in the coffee industry compete indirectly with those in the tea and soft drink industry because all these serve the same need of the customer for the refreshment. The existence of the close substitute is a strong competitive threat because this limits the price that company in one industry can charge for their product. If the price of the coffee rises too much relative to that of the tea or soft drink, coffee drinkers may switch to those substitutes. Thus, according to the Porter, substitute limit the potential return of an industry by placing a ceiling on the price firms in the industry can profitably charge. For example, the price of the tea puts a ceiling on the price of the coffee. To the extent that switching costs are low, substitute may have a strong effect on the profitability of the industry. The more attractive is the price performance ratio of the substitute product, the more likely they affect an industry's profit. In other words, when the threat of substitute is high, industry profitability suffers. If an industry does not ward off the substitute through the product performance, marketing price, or other means, it will suffer in terms of the profitability and growth potential in the following circumstances. It offers an attractive price and performance. The better the relative value of the substitute, the worse is the profit potential of the industry. For example, long distance telephone service provider suffered with the advent of internet-based phone services. The buyer switching cost to the substituting is low. For example, switching from a proprietary branded drug to a generic drug usually involves minimum switching cost. A strategy should be particularly alert to changes in other industry that may make attractive substitute. For example, improvements in the plastic material promoted the automobile manufacturer to substitute plastic for steel in many automobile components.